guys, it's Queen Nisha, and in today's video, I will be reacting to episode 11 of Dead On, A Princess of Snow and Blood. So let's go ahead and get started in 3, 2, 1, go. And I think what? The show ends next week? Which, oh my god. You know what? No, let me check that real quick. And shit, I didn't put my damn phone. J-O-R-A-N. This shit is next week! Okay, hold up. Hold everything. How are you going to end this show by next week? I mean, I love how they're adding, like, sound effects-ish. You would think that they would wait for the final episode to do that, but okay. Hold the F up. We only got one episode left before this show is done. Oh. Damn. Yeah, I know. Great. I have a really bad feeling about this. Especially with the fact that this damn show ended next week. Oh. I don't know. Oh, you finally show up for her so that she knows that you're alive. Oh, I'm so happy, but bitches are together again! That's what happens when you're pregnant, babe. No. You know, you don't have to do this wrinkle. But once again, you don't have to do this! Damn. Yeah, I don't think that was supposed to happen, because that hurt like a bitch, didn't it? Well, she might kill you first, but that's okay. Yeah, but it's better this way. I know, I mean, because you've changed a lot, babe. If only Asahi could possibly see her now, even though Asahi didn't like her. Well, damn. Shut. No. Is a baby coming? Oh, fuck. Oh, this is the worst time to be having a baby. See the head? Pretty. I see. Bruh, I can't believe this. Oh my God. Oh, happy. Oh my God. No. Too. Oh, God. Haven't even fucking watched yesterday's Fruits Basket. This is too much. Because she still wanted to go to school, right? You want to have a better life than this, an education. Oh, so you just want to be an independent bad bitch. I mean, okay, I get that, baby. You want Asahi to use it. But something tells me, Saba's not going to be able to finish it. It's only going to be Asahi in the end. So, honey. Next week is the finale. The last time I felt like this was Akudama Drive, the week before the fucking finale. And I was like, oh, Kanaka, we're not gonna go ahead and kill these last two Akudamas, right? Like, you're gonna let them live with the kids, and it's until, you know, the Akudamas themselves get older themselves and die, and then it's just the kids again, because you don't want the kids to be lonely. This is like this. This is her last mission. The one thing that she needs to do, and everything will be over. Do I still think she's possibly going to kill herself at the end of this? A little bit of yes and a little bit of no. Now that Asahi is alive again, there is a possibility that we're going to see this in the final episode. Them together, happy, and somewhere far away from this, and to be able to start a new life. I'm glad that she was able to see both Hana and Asahi again, but something just tells me, because let's go back a couple of weeks ago when we all sat here thinking, you know, hey, Asahi is dead, laying in her own blood, freaking pile of blood everywhere, and no matter what, I was like, alright, Asahi's dead, she's now done. Asahi's now gone from this show. Straight up. I was like, if this show does not end with Sawa making, like, doing, finishing the job, finishing everything that she has to do, and then in the end, you know, as she told Nana, when this is over, will you die with me? And Nana's over here like, yeah, you know what, I'll do it too. Like, because we've been on this this journey together for such a long time that it needs to see, or reach its conclusion. And so if that means her dying by the end of this, it makes the most sense. But now that Asahi is back, I have no idea how the fuck we end in this show next week. Honestly, like, once again, this is very underrated as fuck. And I hate the fact that there's not a lot of people talking about this show. There probably was, but, you know, your girl is hella busy that sometimes I don't even have time to check things. I don't even know how I'm able to, like, edit something and, like, fucking watch TikTok videos for, like, 2 hours straight. Or do anything, because I'm always so fucking busy with shit. But, oh god. I'm scared. I am so scared. Because once again, the last time I was this scared was the finale of the finale of Akudama Drive. Like, finishing episode 11, and when Hacker dies in episode 11, and the only ones that are left are brother, sister, Swinnerland Courier, you're literally sitting here looking at the preview, and then you're looking at the opening, you'd be like, hey, you see this in the opening? Swindler's standing in front of a cross, and then you see a tree, and a fucking courier, and you're like, Kanaka, are you really going to kill these last two people? Like, yeah, I know, once again, as someone who is a part of that fandom, still, even though there are certain things about that fandom where I'm like, eh. no matter how many times, like, I see someone, or when I got into Danganronpa, or even Akudama, or even 999, I was like, yeah, you're gonna kill these two, like, no, you're gonna leave us with a couple of characters left, right? Like, no. When sometimes a person says, I'm killing all my characters, they really mean, I'm killing all of my characters, but really, deadass, next week, anything could happen. Anything can and possibly will happen, and honestly, I'm just really, I'm scared and excited at the same time. Oh god, but honestly, deadass, however this is gonna end, it's gonna be good. Might even make me cry. You already got me with Asahi returning, and so I don't know how in the world you're gonna trump this episode. But other than that, guys, that is my reaction view towards episode 11 of Jedha and the Princess of Snow and Blood. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like, really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel, I make videos every single day. Join the Master Squad, and of course, I will see you guys officially, y'all, next Tuesday for the final episode. Bye, guys.